Now let's take a quick look at the axillary artery itself. The axillary artery is this one here. The axillary artery starts the outer border of the first rib, which is where my finger has disappeared, and it finishes at the lower border of the teres major, which is here. So this is the extent of the axillary artery. It is bridged over by the pectoralis minor, and this is the pectoralis minor. So therefore, the portion of the axillary artery proximal to that is referred to as the first part. The portion behind that is referred to as the second part, and the portion from there to the teres major is referred to as the third part. The first part has got one branch, that's the superior thoracic artery, which we cannot see because it is high up here, and it supplies the chest wall. The second part has got two branches, and we can see both the branches here. First branch is this one, which I have lifted up here. This is the thoracoacromial artery. The thoracoacromial artery has got a very short stem, and immediately thereafter, it pierces through the costochoracoid membrane, which I told you was in this region, and it has four sub-branches, and we can see the four sub-branches here. The four sub-branches are the pectoral, the deltoid, the clavicular, and the acromial. The next branch from the second part is this one here. This is the lateral thoracic artery. This is one part of the lateral thoracic artery, and the other part of the lateral thoracic artery is here. It was running like this. We had to cut it because we had to reflect the skin. This is the other end of the lateral thoracic artery here. The lateral thoracic artery is the one which runs with the long thoracic nerve of Bell. This is the second branch from the second part. Coming from the third part of the axillary artery, we have three branches. This is one branch. This is the posterior circumflex humeral, which accompanies the axillary nerve through the quadrangular space. This is the cut stem of the anterior circumflex humeral. The third branch from the third part is this, which I have lifted up here. The third branch is this one. This is the subscapular artery. The subscapular artery is a big branch, and we can see that immediately after it arises, it divides into two further branches. One is this one. This is the thoracodorsal artery. And we can see the thoracodorsal artery runs with the thoracodorsal nerve. Other branch is this one. This is the circumflex scapular. The circumflex scapular runs through the triangular space between the teres minor and the teres major, and it participates in the scapular anastomosis. So these are the three parts of the axillary artery with their respective branches. To continue, the axillary artery then continues and it becomes known as the brachial artery. So below the teres major, this is the brachial artery. The brachial artery has got many branches. One of them is the humeral nutrient artery, which we cannot see, which enters into the humerus at the point of insertion of the coracobrachialis. It also gives two ulnar arteries, but we can see one major branch here. This is the profunda brachii artery. And we can see it's accompanied by the profunda brachii vein. And the profunda brachii artery is accompanied by this nerve here. This is the radial nerve. And the profunda brachii artery is a very big artery, and it enters through the triangular interval, and then it runs in the radial groove and it goes to the posterior aspect of the arm.
Thank you very much for watching. Dr. Sanjay Sanya signing out. Please like and subscribe. If you have any questions or comments, please put them in the comment section below. Have a nice day.